Good morning, students. In today's video, we are going to discuss about nuclear weapons and terrorism. We are discussing this topic in human rights violation as both of them, means nuclear weapons and terrorism, both of them are responsible for violation of human rights at a mass scale. So first we need to understand what are nuclear weapons. Nuclear weapon is an explosive device, we all know, that derives its destructive force from nuclear reaction. And nuclear reactions, as we have studied in the school also in science, that nuclear reaction leads to massive energy release. And that's why these weapons are responsible for mass destruction. So these are also known as WMDs, that is weapon of mass destruction. Nuclear weapons include atom bombs, hydrogen bombs, fission bombs and fusion bombs. These are different kinds of nuclear weapons. Then powerful nations try to dominate over others through introduction of these kind of mass destruction weapons. The nations who have nuclear weapons try to dominate others as they are more powerful than others because they have mass destruction weapons in their hand. Then use of nuclear weapon is prohibited by Article 6 of the International Convention on Civil and Political Rights, which guarantee the right to life. As the usage of nuclear weapon is obviously a high risk for right to life, so it has been prohibited. The use of nuclear weapons has been prohibited by Article 6 at the international level. Then various resolutions on nuclear disarmament and non-proliferation were passed by UN, United Nations, because United Nations wants to establish peace and harmony at the international level. Now, how these nuclear weapons are connected with human rights? The incompatibility of right to peace and the right to life with the existence of WMD means weapons of mass destruction obviously are not at all compatible with the right to peace. If these weapons will be used, obviously our right to peace will be disturbed or violated, and our right to life will also be violated. The fear produced by the thought of WMD in wrong hands, right? We are always in a fear that maybe these nuclear weapons could go into wrong hands, and by that whatever mishappening will take place in the world, that would be non-recoverable. Right, the effect of WMD on the war system and the resulting drain of resources, as the production of WMD is not a cheaper project. It uses a very great amount of resources, and that would otherwise be available for the implementation of economic and social human rights. If that money would have been saved, that money would not have been used in such mass destruction weapons. Obviously, that money would have been used in the development in the society, and that would have created better economic and social condition of the human beings. So this is how nuclear weapons are responsible for violation of human rights. Then impact on right to peace. The first sentence of the preamble of United Nations says, "We the peoples of the United Nations determined to save succeeding generations from the scourge of war." Scourge means scourge is the, we can say, is a scourge means the curse, right? So the curse of war, obviously United Nations was established to make the international level free from the fear of war. So the preamble says that we want to save all human beings, the succeeding generations, from the curse of war. Then the Article 2 Part 4 of United Nations says prohibition of aggression, that we are bound to prohibit aggression in any form at the international level. Then Article 33 says that there should be peaceful resolution of conflicts. If there are certain conflicts between different nations, those could be solved at a peace through a peaceful procedure, right? Article 28 says that everyone is entitled to a social and international order in which the rights and freedoms set forth in this declaration can be fully realized. If we want to fully realize the human rights which have been given in the UDHR or the freedoms which have been mentioned in UDHR, obviously everyone, every human being wants to have social order to be established. And for that, war and nuclear weapons, everything is a great, great risk. Later on, General Assembly Resolution in 1984 declared right of people to peace. That is, right to peace is now our fundamental right or is our basic human right, which should be given to every human being. Then the impact on right to life, Article 6, Part 1 of the International Convention on Civil and Political Rights says that every human being has the inherent right to life. Whomsoever country we belong to, whatever citizenship we have, we all have inherent right to life. This right shall be protected by law and no one shall be arbitrarily deprived of his life. Whatever is the reason, whatever is the circumstances, nobody can be deprived of this right. The International Human Rights Committee issued a general comment on nuclear weapons and the right to life in 1984. The three main points which were evident in that statement were, number one, designing, testing and manufacturing, then the possession and deployment of nuclear weapons are the greatest threat to right to life, because these are mass destructive weapons. Their designing, their testing, their manufacturing, possession and deployment, everything is a great, great risk to the human race. Not only in event of war, but even in case of human or mechanical error or failure. It is not necessary that these will be used only in situation of war, but else also in certain circumstances, there is a possibility that due to some technical or mechanical or even human error, there is a chance that these weapons could create a lot of destruction. The existence and seriousness of this threat generates a climate of suspicion and fear between states. Whomsoever is possessing these weapons, all others know that they are very powerful and they will always remain in a fear that these weapons could be used by the powerful nations. Then the production, testing, possession, deployment and use of nuclear weapons should be prohibited and recognized as a crime against humanity. So this has to be prohibited by the United Nations at the international level and it should be considered as a crime against humanity. Then the impact on civil and political rights, fear of nuclear weapons or other mass destruction weapons produce a climate in which governments are increasingly prone to enact emergency measures. Whenever there is a situation in which certain kind of risk or certain kind of fear is there that such kind of weapons could be used, in that scenario, government will definitely declare it as an emergency situation. And in emergency, we all know all our rights, all our freedom stands cancelled. These emergency measures infringe civil and political liberties, as I said. It also leads to implementation of poorly conceived counter-terrorism efforts by the government, right? Poorly conceived, why we are saying that? Because to deal with the terrorism efforts, no doubt every government try to plan out certain counter-terrorism measures. But generally, these measures are not well implemented, or we could say well planned. And because of that, various innocent people's life are also in risk, which further limits the civil and political liberties of the citizens. Then some of the human rights issues related to this are torture and degraded treatment of prisoners or detainees, whomsoever are detained in the prisons because of the counter-terrorism measures. They are tortured up to a great extent. Then invasion of privacy of people. The places where the emergency has been declared, obviously those places are searched without any warrant and their private lives are disturbed. Then restriction on their movement in scenario of curfews, the movement of human beings is restricted. Obviously, that is also against our human rights. So such kind of measures, the counter-terrorism efforts, obviously further leads to violation of our human rights. Then is the impact on social and economic rights. As I discussed earlier also, the production of such nuclear weapons require a lot of resources, right? So the cost, whatever we spend in the nuclear weapon programs, obviously that huge amount of money can be saved for certain other social and economic developments, right? Various studies conducted to calculate the cost of nuclear weapon program have concluded that countries are spending very, very huge amount of money, which is in billions and trillions, on these mass destruction weapons. Right? If this amount could have been used to providing millions of people with their right to health, right to housing, right to education, right to culture, right to social security, and all other rights guaranteed to them, obviously a greater and social economic development would have been seen by the society. So this is how our social and economic rights are violated because of these nuclear weapons. Then terrorism we'll discuss in the next video. Till then, have a good day.